हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, आई प्रभा शर्मा वेलकम यू टू द नेक्स्ट कंटेंट ऑफ द इशू ऑफ शेयर्स कॉल्ड फोर फीचर्स ऑफ शेयर्स, री इशू ऑफ शेयर्स एंड द ट्रांसफर ऑफ फोरफिटेड अमाउंट टू द कैपिटल रिजर्व. व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय द फोर फीचर्स ऑफ शेयर्स? द फोर फीचर्स मीन्स पेड अमाउंट इज टू बी फोरफिटेड. इट मे हैपन्स वेन द सम शेयर होल्डर्स फेल्स टू पे द वन और मोर installment called by the management. It means when a management is calling the amount pay which is due to him but they are not paying, then the their paid amount is to be forfeited. So allotment, it can be happen at the allotment money, calls money. In the some cases the money can be forfeited and the allotment can be cancelled. So this is called as the forfeitures of shares. Now what will be the journal entries? Now till now you know the two share capital you have passed. Now you have to minimize the share capital when the allotment is cancelled. So share capital's account will be debited with the number of shares forfeited to the forfeitures account. What it means, you have to divide the share capital amount into the paid or unpaid, and the two share forfeitures what is referring to the paid amount, and the allotment and calls word is reference to the unpaid amounts. Means the you have to divide this amount into the paid and unpaid, and the paid amount is called forfeitures, and the calling areas at the time of allotment, first final call, you have to list called as unpaid amount. So this is the journal entries related with the forfeitures of shares. And now I am moving to the next journal entries. That entry belongs to the forfeitures at par. Now I am moving to the forfeitures of shares at premium. Sometime the premium amount is paid. When it's a premium amount is paid by the holder, that means the at par the forfeitures will be done. But if the holder didn't pay the premium amount, then only this entry will be passed. The premium account will be debited in addition to the share capital. When I'm taking the share capital, it means this is listing with the face value of a share, and the security premium is the additional amount, and it can be attached with the allotment and calls. You may have to attach. When it is attached here, you may have to attach with the allotment and calls also. So this is the entry when the premium amount is unpaid, only then the security premium will be debited. And then two share forfeitures, that means the paid amount out of this and the unpaid on the allotment and calls will be written down in the same manners. Only the one thing is going to be changed: the premium is debited and the premium is credited along with the allotment or calls where it is attached. And now the entry is here. One entry is for forfeitures of shares at premium. Case is 500 shares having 100 10 each. If one shareholder is holding 500 shares at 10 each and didn't pay means out of 10, I am referring didn't pay 4 rupees include premium. When it is listed here including with premium, it means the premium is not paid. When the premium is not paid, then the security premium will also be debited. And the first and final call is not paid, allotment money is not paid, first call money and final call is not paid, but what paid? That is only application money is paid, and then the shares forfeited, and reissue will be done after that. But you may see, first you have to pass the forfeitures entry. How will you pass the entries? First you have to see the called value. Here the question is not telling the called value. It means the, till the final call is referring, it means the all the value is called rupees 10. So the share capital will be taken with the value of called up. Out of the called up, then you may have to divide the paid and unpaid. So where the share capital is 10, you have to write down the figure with 10 also. Security premium is with the 2, so you have to write down 2 in front of the security premiums. Now the when the 2 is listed here, premium is attached with the allotment, so the face value is given 4. 4 word is reference to including premium. It means 2 plus 2, 2 related with the share capital and 2 related with the premium. So here the word is 4, that's why when the premium is there, the value of premium is also attached with the face value to the share capitals, means 4. and then the first and final call is 3. So when I am talking about the share 4 features, that means I have the need to calculate what is paid. So what is paid in case of we are ignoring premiums now. So you have to take the first is the allotment with the value of 2, and then the first call with the 3. That means the total 5 is called as a share capital. Rest of 5 is the face value is called as the application money, which is already paid 5. So listen again. The in front of the share capital 10, security premiums 2, allotment with 4, and first call with 3, and the share 4 features with 5. So you have to multiply all these figures with the 500 shares. So you may derive from these figures the share forfeited only with the 500 multiplied by 5, which is paid 2500. So this is the scheme. Suppose here the word is listed. Premium amount is already paid. So what will happen with this entry? You have to delete security premiums with the 2 rupees and immediately share allotment will remain with 2. So this will be only the difference between the par and premium. When it is premium, premium is listed, attach the value of the premium where it is listed. But if it is already paid, you ignore the premium and don't take the value of premium along with the item also. So this is the, but the forfeitures value will remain same in the both cases. Now the question is reissue. After the forfeitures, the company can reissue these shares to public. Then entry will be passed bank account debits to the share capitals. First you have to pass this entry. Share capitals will be credited with the amount of paid up. If the question is not telling you the value of paid up, up to the called up value you have to list here. If it is saying fully paid up, that means the value of face value of the shares you have to take here. So here the word is referring the 200 shares forfeited on which 600 paid. If you want to pass the entries of the forfeitures, you may pass share capitals account debit to call-in areas and to share forfeitures. Share capital account debit 200 multiplied by 10. And then the call-in areas with the 400 is given as, and the forfeitures is 600 already given. 600 has been already received. When the 600 received, it means the forfeitures value is 600 in the entries of forfeitures. And the rest of the items will go to the call-in areas. And next entry is because this refers to the reissue. Now the reissue means the bank account debit with the 1800 already given the reissued value, but share capital will be listed with the paid up value. When the question is not highlighting here, it is assumed it is at full value 10, that means 200 multiplied by 10, 2000 paid up value. Now the difference 10 with 200, it is called as the difference is share forfeitures account is debited. So already received 600, now that is the gain. But now when I am debiting it is a loss 200. So what is the remaining amount of the four features? That is 400 is again now in our hand. So the four features account debit to the capital reserve is to be calculated by deducting 600 minus 200, now minimize, and then 400 is the now capital gain. So this is the scheme of related with the reissue of shares. So thank you.